Peace and Blessings, my Afrocentric Home Decor and Style channel. And we are doing a live video today. My husband has the camera, and I told you that I would bring this video to you. So first of all, happy holiday, happy Memorial Day for all the black men and women that have served for our country and their freedom. Many have served in the Civil War, fighting for their freedom from the enslavement Holocaust and beyond, and we give reverence to them. We support them, and we understand that at the time they were doing the best that they could, they were doing something, and I give thanks for that. And in honor of those men and women, my ancestors, your ancestors, our African ancestors, African-American ancestors, we are going to commemorate those ancestors by doing what I told y'all today we were going to talk about. And I was going to actually show you where the picture books. Now let's just talk a little bit about picture. Picture books, I've always wanted picture books. I mean, back then it was picture books of like Gordon Parks would do like a picture book where you have all his photography and it's always about black life and black images. I loved them. Picture books have been around since I've been a kid and maybe even before that. And picture books can come in many genres, whether it's music or jazz or band, we like to call it instead of jazz. So they say jazz, the name jazz is actually a derogatory term, heard that many years ago. And it's a term given to us by the others instead of ourselves. So some people coined it. Some of the folks out of Louisiana jazz scene called it BAM, Black American Music. So we're going to have some images, picture books from that. And I'll tell you a little about picture books. Also, Gullah Geechee images, images of home life in the Gullah Geechee, Southern South Carolina area. We have a lot of these African warriors. I know you've been wanting to see the Ethiopian peoples of the Omo Valley. You've talked about that a lot. I got an actual artist book that I want to talk about. Let's show you some black art books. And it's a variety of others. So, picture books. What's a picture book? It's a book that's usually, they call them coffee table books. And it's usually a book that sits on your coffee table. But, you know, in reality, it could sit on your bookshelf. It could sit on a plant stand. It could sit next to you, anywhere you want, and it's a book that people look at when you're going to get their beverage, or you went to the restroom and when you're in your house, or just giving them time to have to soak in all the energy. Remember last video, y'all, I told you that what I realized is that when a lot of people come in here, because my husband and I were so used to being here, I know I forget that to allow people when they come in to soak it all in. It's a lot from the time they hit the front door to the time they get here, and I'm so busy asking questions, talking to them, that I don't always allow them to come in and feel. And so that's, to me, like, picture books allow you to do that. It allows your company to be in their own little space and to be able to see images of themselves, because you know how important that is to me. So I'm going to let you put my glasses on for this, but we're going to get started. So the first book that I have to get started with is the Ethiopia People of the Omo Valley. Why I love this two-book set, and my husband said he paid about $200 for it. So for the system, like I said, they found it for $75 on eBay. If it's in good condition, if you like the condition, you should definitely buy it. And he said it was, of course, worth every penny. So we're going to come, I'm sure he's going to get a little closer. So Ethiopian People of the Omo Valley. So this is book one. This is Customs and Ceremonies. And so I just want to just, I'm not going to go through every single page. Now, this is such a great book that I say, unless you had another one that was inexpensive and you wanted to take the books out and put them in frames and make them, you know, artwork around your home, you could. But, of course, usually books that cost maybe in this amount, you might not want to do that. Again, you might find one somebody's selling for $25 and you go, hey, you know what? I want to take these pictures out. I know for my husband, he's often inspired. Like, I love these. This is gorgeous. Like, this could be, you know, my tribe people. My husband often gets inspiration from these books, and he'll do paintings from this book. Did you ever do one from this book, babe?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you did. Yeah, so my husband has done from this book as well. So if you're an artist, be inspired. But, I mean, your folks would love to actually see. Look at these beautiful pictures. I mean, the photography is amazing. Glossy paper. Just absolutely every page. You don't miss out. And see, I want you to know that the Mohawk is not just for the people of the Americas, the native folks. We were doing this a while, the Frohawk. So this is something, we was not imitating anybody else we saw. Perhaps they were imitating us. Just something to think about. The so-called Caesar and the line. Do you see her hairline? That's also us. I mean, That's what I like about books. It reminds me that we were here first, and most things that we see, it probably was ours. So just beautiful. Look at that. That's just absolutely stunning, the brother in the tree. I love this. Go ahead, baby. So, but of course, many pictures, you know, went through it pretty quickly, but so let me just show you the other picture. So this one is book two, Faces and Body Decorations. And so you'll see, look at that, look at that. I mean, I know we are, y'all. Just look at how gorgeous that is. So this is us really adorning ourselves. And not just women, but men as well. So just checking those out. I mean, don't you think that you're, not just you, your children, your family, but anybody that comes over would so enjoy seeing these beautiful, this beautiful artwork on a body or other place. So this is on people's bodies. So that's the Ethiopia peoples of the Omo Valley. So if you wanted to know what the books look like, of course you know they were more full, but this is one. So let's look at the African warriors. And these books, picture books tend to be heavy. So this is African warriors, which I love this book as well. Look at that fine brother, look at that, look at him! Gorgeous, see them lips, okay. Beautiful sister, look at how gorgeous we are. All these things we're so afraid of doing or trying, like, oh, my hair being short, my hair, color, we already did that. So the red that a lot of ladies are wearing, especially older women, that we already did that. Makeup, this is how we make makeup. Makeup is a little more purposeful. Look at the beautiful, can I see with the glare? That is just, see, that's beautiful right there. So really, it's the beauty. Like, I really love this book. This book is so stunning. So of course, you know, picture books are not just books with pictures. They have text and stories and things about the life and the village life. Sometimes, you know, they're definitely, most of the time, unfortunately, they're from a European perspective, because most of these books are captured by Europeans. So, you know, I will always say, you might not be able to believe everything that you read, but the pictures are worth a thousand words. How stunning is that right there? She probably 100, for us to get any kind of line in our face, she's probably 200 years old. I'm just telling you, like, she's just gorgeous. So yes, I said, no, and the goat, as my husband said. Oh, no, it's a goat. These are camels here. I just want to show you the vividness of this amazing book. So this one, we have many others. I didn't pull them all out, but I just wanted to give you an idea. Again, honey, how much did you, would you say a book like this, African Warriors, cost?
Maybe about $50.
$50, okay. And what, good place is what, eBay? They're going to ask.
No, I think I got that at Barnes & Noble.
Okay, that's good to know. So
and Barnes they're often on sale.
Okay, so Barnes & Noble's, and he got them on sale. So you can actually find them in those places. I'm glad that you know that, so they don't have to think they have to search these, you know, other stores that may not exist in the community. Okay, so that's the African Warriors. Let's do the Jazz Giants. And this is a visual retrospective compiled by Abe, so I know who that is. But just to show you, okay, we don't want that first one. This is Charlie Parker. How cool is this? Look at this. Talk about Memorial Day, right? Come on now, y'all. Look at these beautiful photographs. So if you have that jazz artist or that jazz rather lover, a person that loves jazz, that Coltrane looks like him from here. If you have,
Mitchell.
My husband said no. My husband knows. If you have a jazz, somebody that loves jazz music or black band music, this is Lionel Hampton.
Count Basie.
This is Count Basie. Look at these colorful, beautiful. I've never actually got to look in here.
Monk
and Cannonball Adderley, right? Mm-hmm. Wow, and all the names are there too, just so you know. Now wait, this is Betty Carter. Go ahead. And this is Billie Holiday. And this is Johnny Hodges. Wow. And this is the High Lows. Mm. Oh, okay, good. And this is Sarah Vaughan. Of course, I know that's Frank Sinatra. He did it his way, y'all. Okay. And my daughter loves that song, so I give it to her for that. And Lloyd Roy. Oh, yeah, these are all absolutely beautiful So again, I can see that these are, looks like they're all in, no, not all of them are in black and white. Some are actually in color. Mm-hmm. So it's a combination of color and black and white. I mean, look at that right there. That's a beautiful picture right there. So if you have that jazz artist that loves, or that jazz person that loves jazz music, is that my Louis Armstrong? Mm-hmm. Yes. Then this would be an excellent picture book. And Warren, how much would you say? Where did you get this? You can remember. And
eBay.
How much?
About $25.
eBay, $25. So we're giving you a range. $25.
It's used.
Used, okay. $50, $200. And this was used as well, right?
No, that was brand new.
No, that's right, because I can see it's still in such great condition. Okay, so let's go over to this one. We bought this at Leimert Park in Los Angeles. I will not forget that. It was a black bookstore, and this is Tuk Amin Kintut, as they say. Look at the colors. And I'm going to see if the price is on this. We paid...
It wasn't a lot.
It wasn't a lot, no.
I think it was like 25.
I would say about 25 as well. I would say that 25 to 45, but I think it was more closer to 25, right? Mm-hmm. So look at these images, and what I love about this, us, blackface, they're not doing that thing that a lot of our magazines, you know, other things people do. Look at us, look at this. This is like super gorgeous. And not just the hieroglyphics, but also other versions of black and white, which this is just amazing. I'm sure it's like the guards guarding the tombs. And just look at how gorgeous this is right here. This is beautiful. Oh my gosh, I mean, I'm just in love. Like, I could stop. Can you imagine, like I said again, having people over? Look at the blue color, the blues that we use. Look at this detail. Like, I was saying, this is with Nubian wig. Remember, we did wear wigs. We wore Nubian wigs. So, I mean, there's something to that. And that's why this is King Tut. So, I guess this is probably everybody that's in some ways related to him. But figures of anthropomorphic deities. Look at the gorgeous. This is Sekhmet. I love it. So, this is something gorgeous. Like we said, we probably paid about $25 for this, and you see the beautiful vividness. Again, if this was an extra book or a book that you purposely bought for pictures, this again would make stunning prints at this print in a frame. I love the blackness of this book. I think it's absolutely stunning, and I'm so glad we bought it. So, okay, so we got this one. Now, there's another one. His name is Jonathan Green, very famous Gullah Geechee. So the Gullah Geechee people are the people of the South Carolina, coastal people, Geechee people, and Jonathan Green is one of those people. And so he is an artist. He's a painter, right, Warren?
Mm-hmm.
And so, of course, it tells about his life, and it takes you through all of his wonderful artwork. Like, I saw some of his original pieces, and they were so expensive that I said, let me see if he got a picture book. Again, if this was an extra book, you didn't want to do it as a picture book, you wanted to use this, the prints as and put them in frames and decorate your home, you could do that as well. Vivid colors. He's a great person to bring in color. Like, this is just absolutely stunning images, colorful of his life. I still call it essentially island life. Just absolutely beautiful. So just so you can see. So if you don't know him, look him up. Jonathan Green, very, very famous Gullah Geechee artist, because he paints images of the people in his community, which a lot of artists do. So love his work. So that's the Gullah Geechee art of Jonathan Green. Okay, so I'm gonna go this way. Now we're gonna go to, I wanted to bring this one out. So yeah, I consider that a picture book. So it's African American art and artist. I took a class at college in California, and I love this class. This was our workbook or our textbook. And so basically it talks about all of the black artists, and it breaks it down into time periods. So this is from 1619 to 1865. What I like about this book is it's not just showing you the artists, their art, and their images, but also its text. It tells you about the person, also about the climate. You can see it's a workbook, what was going on during that time, And it really, like, some of the stuff, I mean, like this right here by Henry Osawa Tanner, called The Piano Lesson. This is an extremely
The Banjo Lesson,
extremely popular piece, seen a lot of places. His other one is called The Thankful Poor, another really powerful piece. And so we got 1920 to 1940. So if you wanted to know about art and our people and kind of the evolution of us, this is a great book to actually look at. So let me see if I could, and you'll see images. I mean, just beautiful. Michael Kelly Williams, David Hammons, Margot Humphrey, William Smith, Ben Hazard, all the great influences. And we'll talk about the Miami images. So these are absolutely just a stunning book, and some history included, which I really, really love. And definitely a social evolution of our struggle from the shores of Africa to here. So I really love this book. It's a great book. In the back, I know they even talk about our building and creating furniture and other things that we were very revered for. So beautiful book. Check it out. I think you'll love it. African-American Art and Artists. I'm going to say the black book for last. But this one we picked up at a bookstore, and it was not even secondhand. We bought it, but I'm not really sure. But It was like Moe's or something in Berkeley, a store we were in Berkeley. It's definitely secondhand. And this book is another inspirational book for my husband. Really got some of his art inspiration. So we'll just go through the text. That's Queen Taye, and she is a beautiful queen. I love her. She's King Tut's mother, if I remember correctly. I believe that she's the mother of Akhenaten. Yeah, the wife. Mm-hmm. Yep, she sure is. And she is gorgeous. So they call her the classic beauty. Like, this is what beauty was for us, and we have to return back to it. So, again, just amazing, beautiful, comedic images. And like, that is so gorgeous right there. Like, I'm loving this. Like, after I get off with y'all, we'll sit down and watch these books. Everybody know Nefertiti, who is stunning as well. I love it. And Amarna, a princess. So this is us, y'all. This is us. And this is gorgeous. This is beautiful. I love this. Love this gorgeousness. So yeah, so this is a great book. We really found some great inspiration in general in this book. And I just absolutely love it. So let's show you that. Show you one more. Just stunning. Foreigners seeking asylum. So all the foreigners from Europe that came to Africa, Egypt, Africa, to learn, but also to steal. Let's keep it real. Okay, this one is called Passages. Okay, so I love this book. I love this book. It's by I used to get calendars by these two women. But again, look at that. It was just to start us off. Another thing, baby, how much would you think you pay for a book like this? It's on the front. $7. So it's probably used.
Mm-hmm.
$7. So you can go to, and bookstores themselves have used books, some of the most popular ones. So go inside, or even the smaller bookstores will have. A lot of the African books will be, something
people
that...
People don't buy them. So they wind up putting them on sale.
Thank you. My husband's right. People don't buy them, so they wind up putting them on sale. So go to your local bookstore, and you will find books like this. This is a stunning book. Any one of us. Huh, baby?
Yeah, I did a picture.
Oh, you did? I love them. So I'm inspired by this one, too. This could be anybody from Brooklyn. South Carolina, North Carolina. Like, I love this book. And I have this in my... frame on the wall in the guest room. I actually have this one here because these same two women that compiled this also used to do a calendar every year called Women of the African Arc. I have this girl too. She's just in another picture. And so it's the same picture. I just think this is stunning. Look at us. Look at, like, I mean, I'm not even doing nothing new with my hair, huh? This is all done before. I think I really love that. I love this. My husband and I was doing. We was laying on the rocks in North Carolina, and the art and the yes, this is beautiful. And all of this has meaning. All of these, the makeup, the people, the ceremonies, all is meaningful. And so this is an absolute great book. Now for $7, again, this would be a great book if you got it for $7. You didn't want it to be a picture book and you wanted to use the pictures just for artwork. Like, I would like, she would go, if I had another book, I would take her out right now. She's like super number one. I love this. Even this color, you see the color, the redness of the earth, the clay, and what they're using. I would like, this color inspires me to use it even around the home. So I get, sometimes I get inspired by just them beautifying themselves and using the color as inspiration. And this brother like somebody I know, like I was just saying. Like, of course, the South African. Look at this brother with an afro, just so you know. So just, and the reds, and so very inspirational. So I really love this book. I cut the apricot, so this is called The Black Book. This is the 35th anniversary edition. We got this in Leimert Park as well. I mean, I think we have re-bought this.
Mm-hmm.
But it came in a paperback before. It's the one I grew up with as a kid. My mother, like, made us sit down and look at this book. And some of these images are very, you know, haunting, but it is us. And it's called The Black Book. If you don't have it, it's very easy to get. I bet you can get this on eBay. This is a brand new copy. I bet you can get it for $7, $8, $9, $10. Like, expensive to, inexpensive to probably very expensive. Because it's been around for a long time. And my husband painted this. And you did a great job, babe, when I seen this. Did you sell that one?
No, I think it's...
Okay, so I have it. So anybody that, yeah, my husband painted that years ago. It's a beautiful painting. We don't have enough room. So we go back to the, you know, public sale of Negroes. The enslavement Holocaust, very popular picture there. And it just takes us back. Slave tax received. Can you believe that? And then this is Yasinke, which is very, he did the Amistad revolt. This is the brother right here, Joseph Sinke. And it is, yeah, it goes back, I mean, right. This is amazing. I see my husband. So we can talk about, we pay $27.25. Oh, you got this from Moles.
Mm-hmm.
So this is from Moles, which was a bookstore that was in California. Mm-hmm. Also, songs, so-called Negro spirituals and other songs. So beautiful. These are some of the things that my husband and I actually would collect. Mm-hmm. Maybe like this one right here. One's more with our images, but of course, yeah, they wasn't nice to us. Things from newspaper headlines, and look, it's very powerful. If you ever get a chance, you would want to sit down and look at every single page because it tells a story, but also goes into, you know, our art and influences. This is a bed, what's that, baby?
Quilt.
Yeah, this is actually a quilt. This is actually a quilt, and a quilt, I mean, let's just go back to some of the, I mean, we talk about the Gullah Geechee making sweetgrass baskets. This is very similar to that, and this is actually from the continent. But us coming, this is us here now, bringing our artistry from the continent, us creating quilts. So I say, you know why I love quilts. Quilts are so important. And so, yeah, different tools. So if you are interested, I would highly recommend this book as not just an art piece, but also something that is historical. Black jockeys who won the Kentucky Derby, I mean, factual. We looks like men marching on. We looks like men of war. Now this is, to me, very poignant because, you know, we talk about Memorial Day. And I talked about all the wars that we fought in to free ourselves, to liberate ourselves. So this is a great book, called The Jazz or the Band Greats, and Hambo, where you been, around the world and back again. Hambo, what you do, I got a chance and I fairly flew. Hambo, where you stay, I met a pretty girl and I couldn't get away. I think that's like the onset of rap music, if you really want to know. And then this is just beautiful images of some very poignant folks in our history. And it's called The Black Book. So, ladies, I will probably do a second edition of the coffee table books because we do have more. It's a lot of books. And we couldn't get to all of them, but I wanted to give an example. If you find them inexpensively, you're just starting out, and you want to put African images in your home, African American, all of the African, then consider taking maybe prints out of a a coffee table book or keeping the coffee table book intact and allowing other people to be a part of the experience by perusing them and seeing them in your home. All right, ladies, this is Lisa Marie Goodson. I want to wish you again a happy holiday. I want to thank you for tuning in, and I will make sure that I do more videos so that you can have an experience and you can start your journey to having an Afrocentric home. This is Lisa Marie Goodson of the Black Theory Beauty Transformative Academy, Ancient African Wisdom for the Modern System. Is that right? Kind of. Afrocentric Home Decor and Style Channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Peace and blessings.